To demonstrate this vulnerability, I've created a Docker image based on Alpine Linux. There's nothing special with Alpine, and other Linux distributions work the same, but Alpine is commonly used with containers. So first, we build a simple utility that we're going to use for experimenting with permissions. Then we create the actual image we'll be using for the demonstration. This is just the normal Alpine Linux, but with a normal user account created, with the primary group user, and one supplementary group called additional. Then we copy over the utility program, a shell script, and create a few files. Importantly, the last line here is setting negative group permissions on these two files. Before we test the container, let's see how it's supposed to work. We'll log it onto an Alpine virtual machine that's been set up the same way as the container. What this shows us is that our primary group is 1000 and we have the supplementary group 1001, but also the primary group has been duplicated in the list of supplementary groups. This is the correct behavior for Linux, and we'll see shortly why this is. Next, we run the attack demonstration script. There's a lot going on here, so let's take this output and add some color syntax highlighting. The script outputs the commands being run, and these are shown in green. Command output is white, and the comments are in grey. First, this shows some system information. We're using Alpine Linux and have set up a few files. We're particularly interested in secret.txt, which has negative group permissions set. Members of group 1000 should not be able to access it, but everyone else should. Next, let's see what permissions the user has. As we mentioned, the primary group is duplicated and is shown in the list of supplementary groups. We'll use the permutil utility to open the file and see that this fails. That's because the group 1000 is blocked from opening the file and the current effective group ID is 1000. So let's try bypass that restriction. We make a copy of the utility and make it set group 1001. This is allowed because the user is a member of group 1001. Now, when we run the set group version of the utility, we can see our effective group ID has changed to 1001, but we still can't open the file because group 1000 is still in the supplementary group list. But how does this work in a container and not a virtual machine? We're going to run this container in Kubernetes, so we need to set up a pod definition file. We'll pull the image from Docker Hub and just get it to sleep indefinitely so that Kubernetes doesn't think that it's failed. It will run as the user we set up with ID 1000. Next, we'll create the pod and open a shell in it. If we run the utility program, we'll see something unusual. The primary group is set up properly, but the supplementary group list only has group 1001. The primary group, 1000, has not been duplicated and included in the supplementary group list. This is the vulnerability that we're going to exploit. We run the attack demonstration script in the container, and again, let's look at a highlighted version for clarity. The beginning is all the same. We're still using Alpine Linux and still have the same file set up. The group list is different though. The supplementary group list does not have the primary group included. So let's try to access the file we want. This doesn't work because when checking permissions, Linux uses both the effective group and the supplementary groups. Our effective group is 1000, so we can't open the file. But now let's try with our set group program. Now we can see that effective group ID has been changed, and now group 1000 has been dropped. We can open the file and bypass the negative group permissions configured. We can work around this vulnerability. Let's delete the pod and create a new one, which has the allow privilege escalation parameter set to false. As before, group 1000 is not present in the supplementary group list. However, when we run the attack script, it doesn't work. The reason is that by disabling privilege escalation, we've stopped the set group executables from working. So our effective group ID is still 1000, and so access to the file is blocked.